Oh my goodness. This thing just hit like a ton of bricks right at the front. Right at the front.
What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. This is Mike. It's Thursday. I'm looking to get out on the water. It's expecting to have a little bit of weather front coming through that's going to bring on a lot of wind and rain. We're actually getting some of the rain right now, so I guess we're just waiting for the wind. But what we're going to do, just going to change up the spot a little bit. Nothing really too different as far as how we're going to, like fishing for bass again, or anything else that might bite in the spot I'm at. We're going to throw SPs again. I did pretty good lately with sand eel color and laser shiner, so like a silverish color. It should represent some of the bait that's in here. Gonna wait out a little bit too. Been doing a little bit of that with some of the back bays and everything like that, and been having some success with it and everything. So gonna just get all geared up, ready to go, and get on the water.
Alright, so we're not bringing a lot of crazy stuff in here into this walking, exciting environment. Just a bunch of plugs, mojo. I'm gonna just change the lure color real quick because, it's not that I got anything against blurple. It's really great to me, if you couldn't tell by how used and abused this thing is, but I got something that might work better. At least I think I do. So, we're gonna get started. See if we can get into them. Oh, so we'll try a couple colors today. I'm gonna try blurple as it gets darker. And I did pretty good on the sand eel one the other day. So we're gonna pop this old bird out and see if we can't get on him. Using something that looks a little like the delicious bait that they're feasting on, which I would assume are small herring or shad or shiners. Beats me. All I know is that it's been working pretty good. So we're just gonna rock and roll with it, see what happens. See if we can get into them here. And yeah.
Okay, so it's pretty much the same standard retrieve that we've used before in the last video. I cast it out, I'll jerk the rod tip a couple times. Standard stuff. SP minnows, they're known to dig into the water as you retrieve them. The more current you have, the more they'll dig. I'm working with a channel which is out in front of me. I think it's about like 5 or 6 feet deep, and everything else around is maybe like 2-3. So, it's somewhere you can wade and, have a lot of accessibility, depending on where you walk. The other reason I chose this SP color is because it simply looks a lot like a lot of the bait fish that's swimming around in here. You can use a cast net to try to figure that out, but for what it's worth, it ended up being the perfect lure for this trip today.
There we go.
That didn't take long. That did not take long at all. Yes, sir. Okay, come on, bub. In and out. Whoop. Crush barbs for the win, baby. That's how you do it.
All right, so these guys are here.
These guys are here. That's what I like to see. All right, let's do it again. They're here. So that's two fish and a few casts. This one's actually got some size to it too. I like this. Come on. Oh yeah, come on. Come on. Yeah. That is a filmed keeper bass. I like it. All right, so we're gonna get this guy unhooked, get a quick pick, and get back on him. And we got a measurement. We're gonna get a nice release on this bass. Come on. Beautiful bass. Beautiful bass. Practice your catch and release, guys. We want these things to thrive for a long time here. Fins are up. Everything looks good. And off she goes. I love it. So, five casts, two fish, one's a dink, one's a keeper. More importantly, I got this place to my shelf. So that's cool. All right, so the action has slightly died a bit after that fish. Oh yeah, come on. Come on. I can do this all day, baby, come on. I could do this all day. I could do this all day. Mojo power. All right. Oh man, they are just inhaling this thing. Like these fish come in waves. Like they'll you'll pick off a few of them. The action might die for a little bit. Don't let that be a discouragement, if anything. Like I said, don't let that be. I didn't even get a crank on this thing and it had the hook. Oh my goodness. Oh goodness, come on. That's something. He's not decent, another little decent one. Unless I snagged it. No, he's looked pretty good. Yeah. Hi there. Boogie on, little bass.
Woo! Well, that was fun. A little wind, good amount of rain to start it off. It seemed like that's when the bite was the best. As soon as we had an east wind when that started, and as soon as it shifted to northeast, rain stopped, wind change things up and we might just stop. I don't know if it's just, you know, I got too far into the outgoing tide or what, but regardless, it was really great. We had a really good outing for this afternoon. If you like this, then awesome. Stay tuned for the next episode. Tight lines.